Charlie Kirk, shot in the neck by a sniper during a university event. Irina Zarutska, stabbed in the throat on a train. Two lives lost in just a few minutes due to massive hemorrhages caused by assassins. Deadly hemorrhages. Not necessarily with the latest technologies. Here's how innovative technologies could have saved them, and how to develop modern emergency equipment to save victims in the future. During a neck injury, the brain suffocates in just a few minutes. But if we quickly replace the blood with cold saline water to cool the body, it protects the tissues for several hours. This gives time to operate and save the victim. It's called EPR, or emergency preservation. Next, the hyperbaric chamber. Imagine operating in a pressurized bubble that dissolves oxygen into the water and body fluids. No need for blood to oxygenate the brain, the cold water becomes sufficient. We can add extracorporeal oxygenation via ECMO and the injection of marine worm hemoglobin if necessary to preserve the patient longer, reduce sequelae, and accelerate regeneration. To make interventions fast enough, we need to install this equipment in emergency vans. Imagine if all emergency vans were equipped with them: cold water pumps, portable mini hyperbaric chambers, or van pressurization, mobile ECMO. Within 5 minutes of the victims, they control the bleeding, stabilize the body, and head to the hospital. For cases like Charlie Kirk and Irina Zarutska, near a campus or train station, survival chances go from 0% to 70 or 80%. This isn't science fiction. The military is already testing this on battlefields. Share to spread this concept and save lives. Subscribe. If this video is successful, we'll launch a fundraiser to make this project a reality in civilian life. This innovation is the future of emergency medicine. What do you think? Say it in the comments. Don't forget to like and activate the bell to stay informed.